cables up and last, and your seat back in a full upright position. We'll be on the ground momentarily.
In the center.
Down.
It shows you.
Oh, maybe
we'll eat right away. Hiya, Mawa.
Where's your feet?
Whoa, he
almost fell.
Best summer.
Hold on to the log, man. This way, guys. Where's the log?
Where's the camera?
Yeah, they wore black shirts. They
called
it black.
No,
not.
Michael, you see that?
Thank you.
Was mit deinem Zimmer, ja? Dankeschön, halt da was auf.
Is only a simaklala. So why should I begin to mention Mashavurach Marta Gushim from the first day of Sukkot if bringing rain?
So the Beis Halev is traveling back, and on nighttime he reaches an inn. He knocks on the door, and all of a sudden he says, "Who's there?" Whatever. He says, "What?"
Thank you. Where's Harry?
Somebody threw a chip in the salad.
Well, it was meant to be funny. What do you think?
You remember
How's the falafel?
Very, very good. Especially the French fries.
You want your health, right?
Special tour, Herman.
Yeah, it's
great. Dovid.
Yaakov also hung out there, and he had his palaces over there. That was also the place where next day his palace blasphemy against the king, Kishvinyad. On what basis did Yaakov...
No way, that's the West Bank.
What?
No.
So it's called Pusha Sagel, who was known as the road, which is as straight as a ruler.
The Mishmah Gomot came is here. Shechvah Yod HaShchalva at State Alpha, which should be in a few minutes. We'll eat lunch there, and then we'll go into the ancient synagogue.
Having a good time here?
Yeah.
Hot springs, nice, beautiful hot springs, and they were very refreshing. Even at the time of the Tanaim and Amaron, Rebbe and others used to go down here and bathe in the beautiful hot springs of Hamad Gader.
Please. How are
things going? How is
it? Baruch Hashem, very good. That's out from Hill. That's so cool.
No, it's a lot of fun. Very good. Tour B is excellent.
Some are young guns, some are older.
We're young and half, but too.
And our priest buried him with his two sons, Yehuda and Chizkiah.
And
How was it?
It was fun.
Was it good?
It was the best trail.
Yeah, do it, Svika.
Yeah.
Why? Even looks better than a kosher delight. Get in.
The left, by the way, is a place called Muchaka. I told you the story of Eliyahu HaNavi where they made the fire with the Nevi'i Habal. That was up in the mountains on the left. It happened right over here. I told you I would point out the spot. The name of the spot is called Muchaka, and that's for the whole debate.
Okay. You kicked out first.
Way to go!
Hey, cool.
Who's there? Who's there? Cool.
Ow,
careful.
Careful, you guys.
Careful. How are you?
Go under.
You can't get through there. You gotta go on a diet.
Rabbi Teitelbaum,
I'll be the camera. I gotta fix my hair to be on camera.
How are you feeling, Dovid? Okay? Better go straight to the bus, maybe.
How far is it?
You know where you were going? You keep moving.
I'm gonna do that. It's a point walk.
It seems a little point.
Commercial break.
Oh, it was really great. Yeah.
This is so cool. Thank God I went to stay on it. Only in Israel is sweat.
Channel 4, Channel 2, Channel 7.
Whoa!
not great. It's incredible.
Where's the hamburger bun?
It's me.
Where is the bun?
And how's the bun?
It's good.
Ketchup, okay, engine.
This is my second one. Right. Come on. I'm not going to put my hand in there.
Enjoy the trip down in the water. How was it?
Great.
Huh?
Great.
And the hamburger's good?
Hi again.
Hi. Look at this chest.
Yeah.
How about this stuff? Let's try another stuff. How about scrap?
Kimcha asvicha leman divarei.
We'll reassemble there. Not move from there, okay? I'm going to send somebody not to hold them there.
Also, read it. We are now in a shul named for a base of Bana'at. Was an Amoyre, the time of the Gemara. His grave, his seal, is right over there. The last very part of hanging up here. And we also read the Torah. In other words, there's no special.
You're up there. How's it doing there? Kids got hurt.
You don't have to use hatch.
No!
Thank you.
the machsanim, where they held all the food, and the food was kept as if it was refrigerated, in perfect condition. And then we'll go up there to the northern palace, we'll come down all the way.
Every day they added more and more water to be able to exist here in all conditions, including
okay. The water comes. The only thing is it.
No.
There are certain excavations here that prove that this city was a time, city used at a time of Shlomo HaMelech.
I'm reading it now.
see.
Red, blue, purple, many colors.
Yeah?
Vamos. Misrak Shoslav Uvot Alolam, Shlok Rahama Sayyidinu, Tishdenu, the Hino Hazar Rahmin, Venak of Nikor Renu, Tishmako Tahmenu, Kiel Shumet was Tahmata, Roba than I shall make you laugh.
שהצמח הזה הוא...
אנחנו נמצאים עכשיו באזור עמק הירדן, והוא שבר גיאולוגי מהגדולים בעולם, מפגש בין שתי לוחות.
Upstate New York and hike a lot?
Nothing.
How about there's a crowd? I have more feet on them.
Yeah.
Except for quarrels.
I'm wearing sneakers.
Okay, like, I can't
even
stand here.
Huh?
And you can stand.
Great,
Mike.
It's too shallow.
I'm a race kid.
I'm kind of just leapfrogging.
Ready, Rabbi? Whoa!
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 Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
We're really rough in here. Stay humble. Whoa!
Yeah.
I want to see that collision. You feel the time of the collision.
Stivery.
Hold up! Hold up! The water, guys. Oh, we can stand
it. Time to swim, guys.
Time to swim, guys.
Just watch out for people in black black pajamas.
Go, guys, go.
Big guys under, little guys over.
Go!
If you dance limbo.
Swim under.
Watch it.
Sorry, live from Zakistan.
Move over.
Live from Zakistan. That's what we're recording.
Move over.
Hey guys, where were you today?
Hope you got that on videotape. He does.
No, not like that.
Michael, you see that?
What does the guy do?
Is it?
Remember? What's the guy that's on my server?
No, I'm not going to be
Any rocket man.
On your right, you see the building, which is the Yeshiva of Hebron. Rav Dovid Yar, a Knesset member. And there was also grazing lands that were so bad, and that's why the Elim, the rams that were brought for Beis HaMikdash were usually bred here in Hebron. This is the farthest where they used to bring water to Yerushalayim, the Herodian aqueducts, gather water from a few places in the Hebron Hills, just slightly higher than Yerushalayim, and gather all the way to Solomon's Pool, which will pass later, Bez Hashem, and from there to Yerushalayim.
Yeah. תקשיבו, מה שאתם לא רואים יש לו
send money.
Mom.
Where do you live?
In Paris.
You like him?
Yes, very good.
Better than you thought?
Yeah.
Are you making American friends?
Yes.
Nice boys?
They're very nice boys.
Good, I'm glad to hear that. How do you like the Americans, friend?
Yeah, they're very nice boys.
All
right.
The new section of Yerushalayim called Hanof. Hanof means the mountain with a very nice view, a beautiful scenic view.
Yerushalayim, I can't stop. Yemi.
Kotel Hamaravi. The Western Wall. The last remnant of the wall that once surrounded the Temple Mount, the Har Habayis, upon which the Beis Hamikdash once stood, where Jews from all corners of the earth continue to stream to for nearly 2,000 years to pour out their hearts to their Creator. In ancient times, people would travel for many months, a most dangerous and hazardous journey, just to utter a simple prayer at her side. For this is the closest one can come to the holiest place on earth, the place from which the Shekhinah has never left, where one stands comforted in its shadow. Overcome with emotion and love, inspired by hope, where one's davening is filled with intense kavana, as the Kotel's aura penetrates to the very depths of the heart. Are crowded with requests. A wall which comforts the heartbroken, which looks on with joy. For here the Shekhinah stands silently for thousands of years, listening intently to the Tefila Leoni Kiyatov, Lifnei Hashem Yishpoch Sicho. Listening to the heartbroken and downtrodden. Listening to the tefillos that pour forth with sincerity and devotion. Wednesday morning, June 7th, 1967. Israel Defense Forces broke through the old city. From Shar Ha'ashpot in the south, and the Shar Ha'ariot in the east, rushing through narrow alleyways, through passages of filth and refuse, through the stench of dead legionnaires, surrounded by sounds of fire and explosions, steadily pushing forward, they suddenly stopped. There it stood, before their eyes, massive, bare, silent. The Western Wall, in all its great, majestic awe. Standing in their battle-worn uniforms, the air filled with the smoke of shooting, and their bodies bearing the blood of wounds, still wearing their steel helmets and their Uzis at their sides, they looked up with awe, stepped forward, and touched its stones with their lips. The gates of emotion opening and tears flowing unashamedly. Tears of joy for the great miracle Hashem had made. Tears of sorrow for their fallen comrades who had fought so bravely at their sides, who did not live to witness this day. And then the soldiers began to pray, their words mixing with the sounds of weeping. As past, present, and future all came together in a gloriously triumphant moment that few can ever forget. At last, the wall was ours again. And the Mirza Hashem, it will remain ours forevermore. A wall that for more than 1900 years had been moistened with tears and whose stones were caressed with love and devotion. A wall endowed with eternal sanctity, whose massive stones, though bruised and battered, remain a symbol to those who pray before her. Facing you, one sees seven layers of enormous stones, remains of the wall Hordas built. You can see their carefully chiseled borders, though some are badly worn with age. These huge stones give the wall its tall, majestic appearance. Above these seven layers are four smaller layers of stone, about 3 feet square. These do not have chiseled borders and are probably remnants of Muslim reconstruction. Above them to the top are rows of much smaller stones, an addition constructed in much later times. There are indications that the wall once stood much taller, but was partly destroyed by the Byzantines. Most of her stones weigh between 2 and 8 tons. This one here weighs more than 100. This extraordinary stone in the northern section is 26 feet long and 14 feet thick. It weighs approximately 400 tons. Every day, hundreds of visitors stand before her in silent prayer, touching her stones as if touching the greatest treasure. Some dressed in long black robes, wearing the traditional Yerushalmi hat. Others wearing an ordinary shirt and trousers. Some wearing round fur shtreimlach, and others just casually dressed. Old men, young boys, women, small children. Sephardim, Ashkenazim, Americans, Israelis, Jews from everywhere, their arms reaching up, hugging an old ancient wall, weathered by years of rain and wind. In its indentations, strange underbrush have lain their roots. Some gaze intently, others curious, their eyes wandering about. Some bent over their tillim in deep concentration. They come here to pour out their hearts, to raise their voices in prayer, to cry out in anguish, pleading with their Maker to fulfill their requests. Suffering end? When will the Mashiach come? How much longer must we wait? How much longer must the weeping continue? The Kotel Maharavi, that magnificent remnant of our glorious past, stands towering majestically. A wall that gives us the courage to remain steadfast in our emunah, giving us the courage to overcome the tragedies of the past, giving us the strength to survive the sorrow and suffering of the long, dark, gallous night, giving us the hope that soon, in our day, joined by three more walls. The home of the Shekhinah, rebuilt within. The third, the eternal Beis HaMikdash.
Make sure we don't get any food from Eretz Israel that hasn't been taken too much from it. Also, every day when we daven, three times a day, we should daven just like you were in Eretz Yisrael. Just because we don't have the kotel in front of us to daven, we still have to daven with the same kavana we have when we're in front of the kotel. We should just because we're leaving Eretz Yisrael, the Holy Land, in 2 days, doesn't mean we have to stop doing the mitzvot like Hashem told us to do in Eretz Yisrael. We can still do the mitzvot. Eretz Hashem, if we do the mitzvot Hashem tells us to do, if we follow the Torah Hashem tells us to do, next year may we come back to Eretz Yisrael. Maybe we'll come back to the base of Mikdash and be able to learn Torah, the time of Mashiach.
Carefully.
How good time do you think?
Are you scaring them here?
Well, we have
Hard to have.